How's it going, Nate? Welcome back to the Great Green North. This is the channel where I help get your lawn from brown and disgusting to green and beautiful in under a year. Today we're going to be talking about how to seed bare spots in your lawn after some sort of renovation project, or just the spot died out, either grubs, disease, other problems like that. So without further ado, let's get into the video. And before we get into the video, let me just tell you, timestamps are down below throughout this entire video, and also they'll be in the description, and they'll be on the screen right here, right now. So let's get into the video.
Here we go, folks. This is a side yard update today. Part two. First mow just done. She's looking better.
Okay, so last week I introduced this project, telling you guys what happened and all that stuff. So this week, I don't know if this full video will come out exactly a week from now or a little bit later. We're gonna be going over what exactly happened. What exactly happened since I put down the first app of seed. I'm gonna be putting down a little bit more seed, and I just completed my first mow, and it's super hot outside, so we need to get some water on this baby. So I'm gonna be talking about watering seed, how to properly put down seed, all those good stuff. Okay, so I know that a lot of you are probably yelling at your screen right now going, Wade, why are you seeding in the middle of the summer? Why are you seeding in the middle of the worst time of the year to grow grass? Now I'm gonna tell you, this clip that you guys are seeing was recorded about 2 months ago. So I was seeding in the summer decline. So if you look at your cool season growth chart, you have your fall flush and your spring flush, and then you have that middle median part, the lowest part of growth. And that's where we are right now. We're at the bottom of our summer decline. I think we might have passed it maybe a week ago, and we're hopefully heading out into cooler temps. But without further ado, that is why you're not supposed to seed in the summer. But you can seed in spring and fall. So I would encourage you guys, if you're seeing a lot of dead spots in your lawn coming out of summer right now, please don't seed. I see a lot of people when I go for a walk every day, a lot of lawn companies putting seed in dead areas along the sidewalks, and I'm like, it's way too hot to be putting down grass seed right now. So if you guys are seeing a lot of dead areas around your lawn, just hold off for a couple more weeks. You guys want to seed when temperatures are cooling off. So you want to seed when temperatures are between 8 and 20 degrees Celsius during the day. So right now we're up in the mid 30s, so we're way too hot to be putting down grass seed. But this is what you wanna do. So wait until that season for you when your temperature is between 8 and 10 degrees Celsius. That's how you're gonna get the best results for your seed. Therefore, probably means for up here in Ontario, we're gonna be seeding late May, probably gonna be seeding around late August, early September, depending on the year. Now for those of you who go into winter, you guys need to put down your seed at least 6 weeks before your first frost. So this may come as a shock to a lot of people, but here in Ontario, our first frost is normally the week after Thanksgiving, so about mid-October. So if you guys are living in southern Ontario, in a little bit of a northern section, kind of just above Toronto, you would expect to put your seed down at least the last week of August, or else the winter is going to hit too soon and you're going to have problems with your seed dying over the winter. Now, I always encourage to seed in the fall because that is fall renovation time. That is the best time to put down grass seed. But for those of you who want to seed in the spring, you can go ahead and seed in the spring. All you're going to have to worry about is just a little bit of summer dieback from that lawn before you're going to be able to seed in the fall. But you should be able to get a decent stand of grass like I have got in my side yard from the seeding that I did in this video.
Okay, folks, so here is the results. So as you can see, the seed came out pretty good here and pretty good here. Now, there's still some new baby grass seed coming up there. This area filled in, this whole middle strip filled in very well, as you can see, with seed. However, that area is still brown. This whole area over here filled in really well with seed. I'm actually very happy with how the seed came in. And then this whole area is still looking pretty good. So we kind of look down like that. This is 2 weeks now since we've done this project. So this is a 2 weeks result. So I'm honestly pretty happy with this result 2 weeks later. I didn't expect it to come in this well. Same with over here, we got all this green coming in all the way down here. Still a couple bare spots, but we're gonna fill those in today, preparing for the rain that we're supposed to get tomorrow hopefully watering our seed in.
Okay, so don't go crazy with seeding in the summer, guys. I'm gonna encourage you guys to wait out a few more weeks. I'm gonna be making a video very soon about a fall renovation and what that means. It's coming up very soon, so get planning in your head. You need to find an aerator, guys. You're gonna be able to aerate and overseed your lawn and be able to get that seed. So if you're looking to seed right now and you saw this video, please wait out a few more weeks, wait till temperatures cool down, then you can go heavy with the seed. Now, some of you are probably wondering, what are the different types of grass? You know, you hear people kind of arguing over what the best type of grass is. In my opinion, there isn't really a best type of grass. I personally like Kentucky Blue better than perennial rye, but my lawn is a mix. And most of your lawns out there are a mix. Now, what you wanna do is when you're looking at the bag of seed, it's gonna list different types of seed, just as I'm gonna show you in this clip right here.
Okay, so this is the bag of grass seed I use. Now, you can use any bag of grass seed. Scott stuff works fine. However, I've found that this works a lot better than the Scott stuff. This is their premium grass seed. This is their premium grass seed. I don't have the tag on it anymore, but I'm pretty sure it's over 50% Kentucky bluegrass. Kentucky bluegrass is one of the best grass types, so if you're looking for quality grass seed, look at the grass seed that has the most Kentucky bluegrass. I mean, it's all personal preference, as Ryan Orr and Connor Ward have fought it out over which is better, Kentucky blue or rye, but I'm gonna be putting down this high Kentucky blue blend because this is what I have had success with, so this is what I'm gonna do. Here you go, folks, we found the sticker. So this is 30% Kentucky bluegrass, 30% creeping red fescue, and 40% premium perennial ryegrass. So this is a nice mix of each grass type. That's a pretty high percentage. Normally some of that Scott stuff is only 8% Kentucky bluegrass. So this is a luxury certified quality of mixture, zero weed seeds, and it's really good grass seed.
I would encourage you guys to find a seed mix that has a higher level of Kentucky bluegrass. Because Kentucky bluegrass is the stronger grass for more northern climates up here, I would suggest finding a higher quality seed, which normally has the highest number of Kentucky bluegrass. Lower quality seeds like to cheap out on Kentucky bluegrass. If you notice a lot of your Scott's products, they super, super cheap out on the Kentucky bluegrass, and it's only rye, or they like to use creeping red fescue a lot up here north. But make sure that when you're looking at seed, you wanna make sure that seed is weed free. The seed that I have is certified premium sod grass seed, which means there's not going to be any weeds. The seed's going to come up and thicken up real fast, and as well, it has a lot of Kentucky blue in it, a little bit of rye, and a little bit of fescue. Those are your big three: Kentucky bluegrass, perennial rye, and turf type tall fescue. So turf type tall fescue is a little bit of a wider bladed grass. Bluegrass is a little bit more of that bluer look, a little bit of a wider blade. And rye grass is a little bit of that thin, kind of shiny looking grass. So if you're looking for a Kentucky bluegrass lawn, go check out Connor Ward's channel. If you're looking for a rye grass lawn, go check out Ryan Norris's channel. But I'm gonna just encourage you guys to find a blend that has all the seeds. Just make sure that you have a higher level Kentucky bluegrass, because that ensures your quality grass seed.
So without further ado, let's go and show you how to put it down. Okay, so most people I see getting out a spreader when they gotta go put down grass seed. Now, if you're overseeding, yes, a spreader is the correct thing to use, but if you're just seeding an area that you wanna have fill back in, don't use a spreader, it's not worth it. Just use your hand. Grab a healthy handful of seed. We're gonna bring it over here to this thin area. And you're gonna take your hand and you want to be able to see plenty of seed up on the grass there. That's how you're gonna get it to fill in nice. You want to be able to see plenty of seed, make sure it's gonna fill in properly. Applied your seed properly and you can see that much seed, then it's time to move on to step two.
So the biggest mistake that people make when applying grass seed is they don't make sure that they get proper seed to soil contact. So you want to make sure that seed is touching the soil, so when those little baby roots come out the bottom of the seed, they can root in properly and get established in that soil. So there's a very simple trick you can use to do this. You're just going to take your regular garden rake.
You're going to head over here to the spot that we just seeded. You're just going to take the back of the rake and you're just going to go over it lightly like that. As you can see from before, some of the seed has now disappeared. That's because that seed is working its way into the soil making sure that it is getting proper seed to soil contact. So that's it, folks. It's that simple. That is how you apply grass seed and get professional results in under a week. So you just got to make sure that you throw the seed down heavy, rake it in with the back of a rake, and those are the two steps to apply grass seed and get professional results in under a week. Now let's talk about watering. Okay, so when watering with grass seed, there's a couple important things to take into consideration. So number one, you might want to dial your watering back. So because you're watering so much, if you're watering a half inch every day, your ground is going to get super, super saturated and the grass is just going to take off and you're not going to be able to, because you're trying to stay off of it with mowing, you're going to have some problems. So what we're going to suggest is dial your watering back maybe 20 to 30 minutes depending on how long you water. So for a half inch with me, I normally water for 70 minutes, so I'm dialing mine back to 40 minutes on the side yard. Because I'm watering every day, I'm still making up the same amount of water dose that the side yard needs. It just helps me dial back on the watering, saving a little bit of water. When watering regular grass, we talked about how it's important to make sure that you get down a correct half inch of water and you're watering every 3 to 4 days. Well, with watering grass seed, it's very different. It's not about getting down a half inch of water, it's just about keeping that seed wet. So what we're going to be doing is you just want to make sure that your sprinkler is hitting as much as possible, and you want to make sure that you're not leaving any dry spots, because if you leave a dry spot, you won't get any seed growing in that area. So you want to make sure your sprinkler is hitting everything as possible, and you're not getting any dry spot. You want to also make sure that you're watering frequently. So you want to water every day, and if it's really, really hot and really, really dry, you might have to water twice a day. So just make sure that when you walk up and touch that soil is always wet. You guys see the spot that we hit over here? You can see the water droplets. We're getting full and complete coverage from the sprinkler.
Finally, guys, seed is cheap, so throw her down. This phrase was coined by Alan Hayne, the lawn care nut. And people say, you know, grass seed's not cheap. It's like $100 for a bag. Yeah, but it's cheap compared to sod. Sodding a 5,000 square foot lawn is probably close to $500 to $1,000. Seeding a 5,000 square foot lawn, if you're putting it down at like 7 pounds per thousand, that's probably close to $200-$300. So sod is normally, as a general rule, 10 times the price of seed. So your seed is cheap, throw her down. I see these people doing an entire residential lawn with a little bag of grass seed this big. No, seed is cheap, throw her down. I want to be able to see that seed in the lawn. People say overcrowding, you can get overcrowding, but don't worry about it. Not all the seed's gonna germinate. Only 70% of grass seed germinates from most seeds. Sometimes it's lower to 50, sometimes it's even 30. A lot of the seeds in these bags don't germinate, and that's why you want to throw her down. You want to make sure that you're going to get a healthy stand of grass for all of the work that you're going to put in, watering and all that stuff. So thank you guys for watching this video. I hope this helped you about grass seed. Any questions, leave them down below. I'm going to be doing a question video very soon answering some of your guys' questions. And without further ado, from the Great Green North, my name is Wade Murray. Keep it green.